Competition for jobs among young people is at an all-time high and has led to an increase in unpaid work positions.
The cost of the UK's major cities, coupled with the need for unpaid work, means that young people are turning to more and more extreme ways of life just to survive.
I spoke to Gus Baker, co-founder of Interns Aware, to find out just how far the problem has spread.
The situation with regards to how young people are living in their early years of work really is dire. Look, if you're desperate to make it in an industry, you'll often do anything to get ahead. And if you've got no money, maybe you take out a bank loan. And the interest on that spirals and spirals and spirals. I've seen people who've racked up credit card bills, people who've worked from 9 till 6 p.m. on an internship and then worked from 6 p.m. till 1 a.m. in a bar. These things exhaust people.
The difference between living wage and national minimum wage is huge, forcing young people into this paradoxical situation where they have to find ways to support themselves just in order to get the job that they want.
There's been so many times when we've looked at each other and gone, we're gonna have to go home.
Gina and Jen are advertising creative partners, struggling with the cost of living in London.
We came to London with no money, in debt from uni. We were gonna start couch surfing. You have to come to London if you want to do this job, or any creative job, really. This is the hub of creativity in England. So you have to be here, but you can't afford to live here. So it's the biggest catch-22 ever. There's no way of doing it apart from being creative with your lifestyle and reaching out and meeting people and trying to do creative little jobs just to make ends meet. That's how it works. We came out with great degrees, we got great marks, and yet we have to get up at 5:30 every morning and fly it, or we have to a nighttime dress and nothing and fly just so we can eat.
Being on national minimum wage means that the average salary will be around £866 per month. Now, if you're working in one of England's major cities, over 40% of that will be going on your rent. In Manchester, the average rent is £353 per month. And in Bristol, it's £405. Rents go up even further in London at £665 per month, which is over 70% of your monthly pay packet. It's clear then that rent is the most challenging area for young people living and working in UK cities.
People are living in really insecure housing now. Guardian schemes are on the increase, whereby young people are protecting disused property, able to live there for cheaper rent, not for free, but they can be moved on every 2 weeks. And that gives them absolutely no stability. And without that stability, they can't sort of build lives and build communities.
Johnny is a young writer and actor who recently arrived in London to be close to the jobs he's competing for. He currently lives as a property guardian in a disused care home.
Well, the reason why I'm living here as opposed to just renting is because it's cheap. It's very cheap.
Yeah, and then this is where we live. There's enough bathrooms for you to share. There's toilets in here. It's lovely, and sometimes you get places like this where we are, where it just looks, you know, kind of like a normal home or student halls, perhaps. But then you're living alongside quite sterile, clinical, forensic hospital things, which I find that a bit haunting, a little bit. You know, it's a bit kind of odd. It's a weird way of living. And in an ideal world, I would have a house, you know, and a garden and my own bathroom. But you've got to do what you got to do.
So, is anyone to blame? And more importantly, is there a solution?
I mean, it's not about money. It's not about companies not being able to afford to pay people. The creative industries, where unpaid internships are worst, they've grown all throughout the recession since 2008. What it is about culture. It's about people who say, look, actually in our industry, we're gonna use unpaid young people instead of hiring people. It's about trying to make sure that that doesn't happen and that there's fair access to work, which always includes paying people for the jobs that they do.
Looking into it, I thought I'd find a lot of angry and frustrated young people, disenchanted with the seemingly impossible challenge of living for free in a major city. Instead, I found a group of young idealists whose passion and determination are so strong that they're actually willing to be really proactive within such a daunting situation. So it seems that those most willing to be creative about the way that they live are the ones with the best shot of making it in the big city.